Hi everyone, let's talk about the musculature of the anterior compartment of the thigh. So what you're seeing here is the proximal upper limb. So we can see the anterior superior iliac spine of the pelvis here. The pubic symphysis would be approximately here. We can see a slight contour of the gluteal region there. So just for our own sake of orientation, this is the lateral side, and this is the medial side. The head of the femur would meet the acetabulum at the hip, sort of in the plane of that arrow, and then the knee joint would be there. So in order to get to what you're seeing, a considerable amount of dissection had to have occurred. The skin and subcutaneous tissues removed, the superficial veins and lymphatics are gone, but probably most importantly, the fascia lata, or the fascia that would have encased the thigh muscle, has been removed rather expertly. And this allows us to see some of the musculature here. So the first muscle that I would draw your attention to is the sartorius. The sartorius has the distinction of being the longest muscle in the human body. And it's named the sartorius because it is the tailor's muscle. So it proximally attaches to the anterior superior iliac spine, or the as-is, and distally, and we can't see this here, but coming from the median portion of the tibia, there is the pes Anserinus. Pes Anserinus, translated, is foot of the goose. And what this is a tripartite attachment for several muscles, the sartorius being among them. And so the sartorius, when activated, and it is innervated by the femoral nerve, as are the other anterior thigh muscles, the sartorius muscle is going to be responsible for flexion, abduction, and lateral rotation of the hip joint, as well as flexion of the knee, because it's going to cross the knee joint down to the tibia there. There's another muscle which also originates from the as is there, and that's the tensor fasci lati. The tensor fasci lati is this muscle which I am outlining here. It's running from the as is down to the IT, or the iliotibial band, which we can see here. That IT band is a specialization of the fascia lata, and it's running down to the anterolateral, or Gerdes, tubercle of the tibia. And when this muscle is activated, it also is responsible for abduction and medial rotation of the hip, much like the sartorius. And it's also a weak extensor of the knee. And its primary importance in terms of function is to provide stability, postural stability, to the lateral knee. The remaining muscle or muscle group that we can see is the quadriceps femoris group. So let me outline that here. We can't see all of it, but the quadriceps, quad meaning four-headed muscle of the femur or thigh, consists of four muscles. There is the rectus femoris, which I'm outlining here for you now. That rectus femoris muscle also takes its proximal attachment up at the anterior superior iliac spine, and it comes down via its tendon to the patella or the kneecap. And from there, the patellar tendon continues on down to the tibial tuberosity. And so what we have is this shared tendon from all of the muscles of the quadriceps femoris that contains the patella. And then we have the patellar tendon to continue from the patella down to the tibial tuberosity. The rectus femoris all by itself is responsible for extension of the knee joint. So we also have other muscles which we can see of quadriceps femoris. So we've discussed rectus femoris. We have vastus. Vastus means a large muscle, medialis, which is this muscle here. So recall this is the medial side. So vastus medialis is there. Vastus medialis takes its proximal attachment site on the intertrochanteric crest and the linear aspera of the femur, and its distal attachment to the patella, and then the patellar tendon down to the tibial tuberosity. The vastus medialis, just like rectus femoris, is responsible for extension of the knee. And if that was the vastus medialis, vastus lateralis should be very easy for us to find. We can see that it's nestled between rectus femoris here and the IT band. The vastus lateralis takes its proximal attachment from the greater trochanter and linea aspera of the femur, and then, yep, you guessed it, via that tendon for quadriceps down to the patella, and then the patellar tendon to the tibial tuberosity. Then finally, we have the vastus intermedius, which is not visible in this view, but if we shoot ahead to this next view, we can see here and there we have cut away rectus femoris to reveal a muscle deep to it, and that muscle deep to it is the vastus intermedius muscle. Vastus intermedius muscle takes its proximal attachment from the anterior lateral femur and through the quadriceps tendon down, encapsulates the patella, and then the patellar tendon down to the tibial tuberosity. And the vastus intermedius, along with the lateralis and the medialis and rectus femoris, are all extensors of the knee. So the final muscle that I would like to draw your attention to is the iliopsoas muscle. The iliopsoas muscle is a combination of the iliacus muscle and the psoas major muscle. Psoas major, as you recall from previous sessions, descends down from the transverse processes of lumbar vertebrae. You can see that here. It's a very useful muscle for understanding the spatial relationships of nerves of the lumbar plexus. And it is going to merge with fibers from the iliacus. The iliacus muscle, part of it's occluded here, but it's taking its origin in the superior iliac fossa, and it comes down. I'll just sort of dash this because you can't see it there. And it joins with psoas major to form that iliopsoas muscle. And it's going to then attach to the lesser trochanter of the femur. And this iliopsoas muscle is going to be the most powerful flexor of the hip joint. So really bringing that thigh into flexion, like a high step, or if you're kneeing something, or if that is stabilized, pulling the trunk up. So to perform a sit-up is something else that you can do with that muscle. Isn't that wonderful? So while we're here, it probably would do us well to mention some of the neurovasculature that we can see here that is supplying this compartment. So we can see coming down here, this is the femoral nerve. You can see it branching out there. The femoral nerve is the innervation for this anterior compartment. We can also see here the femoral artery. Oops. Here's the femoral artery. And it becomes the femoral artery from the external iliac artery. So that external iliac artery, when it travels underneath the inguinal ligament, becomes the femoral artery. There's also the femoral vein. That femoral vein is contiguous with the external iliac vein. So that also at the inguinal ligament is going to transform its name here. And those are some of the important neurovascular elements that that serve this muscle compartment. So we've discussed the anterior thigh, largely its muscles, and a little bit of its neurovasculature. So I thank you for your time. Take care.